This is the Gaumont British News, presenting the world to the world. These are a few members of the crowd of more than 60,000 spectators waiting for the final between Preston, North End and Arsenal. The teams came out together, Preston wearing dark shorts. Before the match, the teams were introduced to Mr. A.V. Alexander, First Lord of the Admiralty. Preston shaking hands first. The lucky team in the toss-up was Arsenal. Hapgood beat Smith, and so Preston set the ball rolling. Preston played grand football, especially in the first half, and they led an attack to the Arsenal goal almost from the word go. There's a thrill in the first 3 minutes. In a scrimmage round the Preston goal, a penalty was awarded for hands. The crowd waited tense while Fairbrother waited for the kick by Leslie Compton. He saved it. That was the first big effort in an afternoon of brilliant goalkeeping. Preston attacking again. And before the game was many minutes older, they scored. Young McLaren took a pass from the wing and zingo! Preston 1, Arsenal 0. A good deal has been said against the holding of this cup final in wartime, but at least it gave the opportunity for the services and other war workers to refresh their minds with complete change. It called for scores of police and others to be on duty, but perhaps they found this duty not unpleasant. It's hard to decide if we can afford this kind of festival today, but we probably work better after it. A bit of fancy footwork from Arsenal. The ball is out on the wing. Swings in to Dennis Compton, and Compton lets it rip into the net. Score 1-1. That was the first half. Both sides were on edge to get a nose in front. Preston attacking again, but they didn't score again. Arsenal again take a turn in the offence, but the game was destined to finish in a draw. So that's how it all ended, but there were thrills to the very last. Ouch!